Global System for Mobile GSM is a second generation cellular system standard that was developed to solve the fragmentation problems of the first cellular systems in Europe. GSM is the world's first cellular system to specify digital modulation and network level architecture and services. Before GSM, European countries used different cellular standards throughout the continent, and it was not possible for a customer to use a single subscriber unit throughout Europe. GSM was originally developed to serve as the pan-European cellular service and promised a wide range of network services through the use of ISDN. GSM's success has exceeded the expectation of virtually everyone, and it is now the world's most popular standard for new cellular radio and personal communication equipment throughout the world. GSM services follow Integrated Digital Services Network ISDN guidelines and are classified as either teleservices or data services. Teleservices include standard mobile telephony and mobile originated or base originated traffic. Data services include computer-to-computer communication and packet switch traffic. User services may be divided in three major categories: telephony services or teleservices, data services or bearer services, supplementary ISDN services. Teleservices. The abilities of a bearer service are used by teleservice to transport data. These services are further transited in the following ways: voice calls, video text and fax mail, short text messages. Bearer services. Data services or bearer services are used through a GSM phone to receive and send data is the essential building block leading to wide spectrum mobile internet access and mobile data transfer. GSM currently has a data transfer rate of 9.6 kbps. New developments that will push data transfer rates for GSM users are high-speed circuit switch data and general packet radio services, which are now available. Supplementary services. Supplementary services are additional services that are provided in addition to teleservices and bearer services. These services include caller identification, call forwarding, call waiting, multi-party conversations, and barring of outgoing international calls, among others. A brief description of supplementary services is given here. Conferencing. It is allowed a mobile subscriber to establish a multi-party conversation. Call waiting. This service notifies a mobile subscriber of an incoming call during conversation. Call hold. This service allows subscriber to put an incoming call on hold. Call forwarding. Call forwarding is used to divert calls from the original recipient to another number. Call barring. Call barring is used to restrict certain types of outgoing calls such as an ISD or stop incoming calls from undesired numbers. Advice of charge. This service was designed to give the subscriber an indication of the cost of services they are used. Furthermore, those services providers who wish to offer rental services to subscriber without their own SIM can also utilize this service in slightly different form. Closed user groups. This service is meant for groups of subscriber who wish to call only each other and no one else. Unstructured supplementary services data, USSD. This allows operator defined individual services. Number identification. There are following supplementary services related to number identification: calling line identification presentation, calling line identification restriction, connected line identification presentation, connected line identification restriction, malicious call identification.